We're in the ballroom of Seattle's historic Stimson-Green Mansion, where lots of great music has been heard over the years since the late 1800s, and that tradition is continuing with our vinyl show musical guest, Shelby Earl. Hello!
Hello!
It's so great to see you.
Thank you for having me.
Now, you know that I've been after you for many years. Some would call it stalking. I say it's persistence, right? But the timing is great because you have a brand new vinyl out, and it is called The Man Who Made Himself a Name.
That is correct.
And it's selling well. Congratulations.
It. Thank you very much.
By the way, what was the record that changed your life?
The record that changed my life? Easy. Michael Jackson, Thriller.
Okay. Good. Yeah. I just want everyone to know that. Okay, so we're going to talk about this one, but why don't we introduce the band? I want to start right here on keys.
Absolutely. Billy Brush is here on the keys.
Hi, Billy.
Aaron Benson on the drums.
Aaron, nice to see ya.
Matt Batey on guitar.
Hey, Matt.
There he is. Steve Baldock on the bass.
Great to have you all here. So your debut album, we were talking about it earlier, John Roderick produced it in 2011.
He did.
And it was Burn the Boats. Then in 2013, Swift Arrows. Damien Jurado.
Correct.
The new record, 4 years later, you made us wait 4 years, is being produced by the very excellent Martin Favier.
Marty Favier.
Let's just go with that.
Yeah.
What is it about Martin that you wanted to work with him? What did you hope he would bring to this project?
I was just ready to do something a little less lo-fi time.
Yeah.
It's sort of a dancier, groovier feel on some of the songs, and the production had to support that. So I thought Martin was the guy.
I think it's turned out that it's very true.
I think
he is. You know, you've been at this for a little over, almost 10 years or so. What do you know about yourself as an artist, or is there something that you know now that you didn't know when you first started out?
Oh, yeah. I mean, when I started, I didn't even know if I could write a song. I just was messing around with lyrics, kind of just learning to play the guitar, and that was just 10 years ago, and so I thought, well, I'll just do this in my living room. No one ever has to hear this. I had been singing for many years, but I didn't know that I could write at all, and it's one of those things anyone who sort of gets into songwriting and gets excited about it will tell you it snowballs very quickly, and then I didn't want to do anything. I didn't want to go out.
I just wanted to be
in the living room.
Yeah,
and so that has been really fun and has progressed, and I feel like my writing has definitely come a ways on this record.
Oh, yes.
So
it's sophisticated.
Thank you. I wasn't going to use that word, but
I'll use it for you.
Thank you.
So you're going to play us a couple of tunes off the new vinyl.
Yes.
And what is the first song we're going to hear?
The first song is the title track. Yes. It's called The Man Who Made Himself a Name.
Awesome. Well, are you guys ready to do this thing? Yes? You girl? You ready?
I'm ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shelby Earl.
He's met you before, but he doesn't recall. He does not recall the light sharp in his eyes. He's met you before, but that was in a simpler time. Now the ghosts, they come at night, and his pockets are heavy with keys to the cities, the weight of his memory.